We've been going for days walking.
I'm in engineering on the other side of the camera, so I'm not used to being interviewed.
You can be on this side of the camera now.
Yeah, I'll see the experience.
You had a what?
I will see the experience now.
You sure will.
Yeah.
Experience it from the other side. Do you need us back a little, or are we too close? This is us walking. Did you get his badge? He wants to get your badge so he can have the correct spelling of your name and stuff.
Yeah, all right. Yeah,
I'll just turn and do. Got it? Cool. I'm Kirk Kelly with Actors Reporting and Live Video Inc. We are at NAB. I hear sirens going off in my head. There's all kinds of excitement here. And Jovan, you are from the other side of the world for this event.
Yeah, I'm from Europe. I'm from Serbia, actually.
Did you even hear a word we were saying? I couldn't hear myself think. Okay, good.
That's a beautiful mic.
I love this mic. We just got this mic here at this show. Man. And you're an engineering guy, so... It's an Electro-Voice,
yeah.
RE50B. They just came out with this?
Yeah, I haven't seen it yet.
Neither did I until this show, and a guy at Electro-Voice is like, try this. And so far, we can have sirens going off in the back of our heads, and it's not drowning us out, even though I'm now tone deaf. So, as an engineer, what brings you to this convention?
Yeah, this is the biggest world convention as I know, and then you have the new developments, and you... In the view from the guys from Europe, this is where you can see a little bit the future, what is happening in the broadcast industry and the broadcast workflows, and also the integration of broadcast and the internet, social networks, and so on.
How is that impacting what used to be the barriers of governments around the world, where you can't air this in my country or air that in your country? And now the barriers of social networking and internet and global broadcast and satellite are changing all of that.
Yeah, I think everything is changing because we have to be aware that everything, that life is speeding and the communication is speeding. So even I started in a classical broadcasting when the television was a TV set without no remote, with an evening chair sitting and sofa sitting.
Was this black and white or color?
I started with color, of course.
I started
watching a black and white television set, even in a rather developing country at the time, in ancient Yugoslavia. We had not every apartment had its own TV set. So on Sundays evening, when there was a family soap opera, there were people gathering around, neighbors coming, friends coming, relatives coming to watch the television. So that, and also I remember from my very youth that I watched the funeral of President Kennedy in my own country.
Wow.
So that was black and white. So it came all to make me wonder to work one day in the not in the industry, I'm not working in the industry, but wonder how the production does look like, and slowly I developed to become an employee, an engineer, and all the others came later.
How have you seen in your time in entertainment, in television and engineering, things change over the earlier years in your career versus even in the last couple of years?
Yeah, in my beginning, there was a, let's say, a much bigger division between the types of typics of the program. So you have news on one side, it was news program, you had entertainment, then the dramas, then the, and it had to speed up and to mix a little bit. Everything is faster. There's a lot more competition in now. Once the people got remote controls, they can go from your channel to another one without getting out of the chair. And then with the satellite, with the cable distribution, even in my country, we are able to watch practically 80 to 200 programs in every household. So nowadays you have to produce a program that somebody is willing to watch, not what your manager is willing, or your politician around, or some guys that are owning or ruling your station want to spread over the spectatorship. You can, you have to, of course, take care a little bit about their wishes, but you have to make a program that people will watch.
Well, and ultimately, as it is becoming more and more the case around the world, the ratings and the viewership will begin to dictate what programming will be supplied, because if they don't find it in their current outlets, they have so many alternatives to go find what they want.
Yeah, that's just it. You just have to be in a very good touch with your spectatorship and to study the potential spectatorship, because you should go towards the new spectatorship, all the guys that that used to do for the secure ones and the steady ones, they had to pass their leadership to somebody else, somebody that is watching the future and that is adapting his job to the future.
What's the most amazing thing, if you had to pick something that you've seen or learned at this show, what would be that most amazing thing?
Yeah, I'm not first time in on NAB, so for example, I've seen the speed camera of 1,000 pictures. That is quite amazing. What picture quality has those cameras that are not only able to shoot many pictures, but many pictures with broadcast quality. On the other hand, I've seen the presentation of James Cameron and in the Christie Pavilion, which showed me the. The way the cinema industry will go with 48 frames, with 60 frames per second. So the problems that I've noticed in the first 3D cinema, I couldn't stay to the end, even if it was Avatar. I had to go out. It was too. Of course, I did. It was on a show similar like this in Europe, in Amsterdam. And it was at 6:30 o'clock after the whole day of the show. A very, very convenient seat and a good place to watch it. But it was too difficult to watch so many informations in 3D for a long time. Now it seems that they found a way to make the 3D more pleasant to watch without the interference of all the details that we are not used to in classical television. And there's several other things what not amazes me, but makes me think is the way that people think here about the second way of connection, mm-hmm. One through internet and one through television, and
a multiplicity of sources.
Multiplicity of sources, multi-platform of showing it and having interconnectivity with your spectatorship.
So thank you for your time today, Jovan.
Yeah.
Very nice to meet you.
Yeah,
hope to see you again in future years.
Thank you.
I'm Kurt Kelly from Live Video Inc. and Actors Reporter. We'll be right back.